travel. Today we are in the city of Merida in the southeast of Mexico on the Yucatan Peninsula. This area is known for its rich Mayan heritage and delicious traditional cuisine. Here they use really unique ingredients like habanero, sour orange, lime, and annatto. We have got a very exciting day planned today eating some incredibly delicious traditional cuisine. So come on, what are you waiting for? Let's get to it.
Este es el panuche.
Ah, panuche.
Este es el lechón.
Ah, lechón.
El schnipek. La cascarita.
Ah,
la carne asada. Cebollita asada.
Ah, sí, sí. ¿Salsa?
La salsa de chitomate. Y vamos a poner el relleno. La molida negra. Huevo.
Ah, huevo.
Y... listo.
We are here at Taqueria La Lupita in the Mercado de Santiago for our first meal here in Merida. Now this is a legendary spot that's been around for 56 years. It's only open for breakfast and lunch and it is just packed with people getting their local food. Now they do some really delicious local dishes here that you can really see the Mayan influence in the food. We have a plate of deliciousness here. Now we've got two different things covered in four different things. We've got panuchos and salbutes, and you can see a difference between the two. These guys are fried and actually have refried beans inside of them, whereas the salbutes are a little bit more puffy. Probably the most important dish here in the Yucatan is cochinita pibil, which we have on our salbutes right here. Now this is a slow roasted pork that's cooked in a pib, which is underground in a traditional Mayan way. It's seasoned with bitter orange and annatto seeds, covered in this pickled onion, and it looks incredible. This is the ultimate traditional dish here in the Yucatan. We also have relleno negro, which is a really interesting dish. It is super black, as you can see from the chilies, which are roasted and toasted until they're black, and it is made with turkey. We've got an egg on top, which is quite unique. We also have a very local drink here, super green, made with chaya. This is chaya con piña, so it's with pineapple, and it's a tree spinach. It's a superfood. It's really good for you, and just look at the color on that. Cheers. Ooh, that's really nice. So you can really taste that chaya. It has just a very green, healthy taste to it. It really does taste similar to spinach, but the piña, the pineapple in there, gives it a nice sweetness too. So it's nice to know you're having a little something healthy to go with a slightly heavy breakfast. I'm good with this. Okay. I want to start, of course, with the cochinita pibil and this salbutes. Look at this guy, it's super fluffy, very different than any kind of just taco, very unique, and everything here is made fresh to order. All right, let's get a nice big bite. That onion on top gives such a nice flavor, but that pork is insane. It is so tender and juicy. and the flavor of it is actually quite mild. It's almost citrusy, rich in terms of meat flavor. You can taste a little bit of the pepperiness from the annatto seeds, but okay, I actually love their salbutes. It's really interesting. It's fluffy, and you can see it's a little thick, like it's not super thin, but it's nice and soft in the inside, and the outside of it actually has a nice little crunch to it. Mmm, okay, that goes perfectly with the cochinita pibil. I'm gonna move on to this relleno negro because I really wanna try the panuche, which is made with the beans actually inside there when they make it. Okay. That is really rich. There's almost a smokiness to it from the peppers because they're just cooked until they're black like that. But it's spicy, really flavorful. That egg is nice on top too. The panucho, very different than the salbutes. Much thinner. Can't really taste the flavor of the frijoles, the beans, too much inside the panucho because the flavor of the relleno negro is just so strong. But I love the use of turkey in this dish. It's very different and very Mayan because they used to eat the wild turkeys here before the Spanish came. So you can just see, look at that fresh turkey. Oh. That tastes like dark meat too, which is really the best part of any bird. Muy, muy rico. Muy rico. Oh.
Gracias.
So delicious. And we're only halfway through. Next up, we've got our carne asada, which is a marinated pork, and we've got some nice grilled onions and a red salsa on top here. And this is the panucho again. Okay. The first thing I really taste is that tomato salsa. It's a strong tomato flavor. It's not really spicy at all. The onions are so nice and roasted with a little crunch to them. And that meat as well. It's really nice. It almost has, has a nice marinated flavor to it. That's really good. And with this one, I find you can taste the frijoles on the bottom a little bit better. You can see them just really cooked inside of there. Look at that. Really adds a nice flavor to the dish. I like this. Last up, what I have been kind of saving for last, because I really wanted to start with the cochinita, but you can't ever go wrong with lechon. Look at this huge chunk of chicharron and that nice lechon pork there. You can see that pork is really important in the cuisine here in Merida. Okay, here we go. That chicharron is so nice on the top there. Has a greasiness to it when you bite into it. That's just so satisfying. And the meat on the bottom is nice and tender. That pico de gallo adds a nice little bit of flavor as well as a freshness to it, which is nice. I just love these salbutes. Definitely more puffy. They're nice and fluffy and give an extra little something to it without being too heavy. They're so different and unique compared to your typical corn tortilla. That lechon, that crispy, slow roasted pork, is always so tender and juicy. I just love it. And you can never go wrong with something that is porky and crispy and crunchy, like the skin or the chicharron. So good. This is such a great local spot to come and visit in Merida. It's a family-run business. The owners, Guadalupe and Pedro, have been so friendly and welcoming. And it's such a busy spot, full of people. The prices are very affordable for what you get, which is very local, home-cooked, Yucatan dishes. We really highly recommend coming here if you ever get the chance because the food is just incredible. And this is an amazing way to start your day. What you need to people? Yes, please. I think that might have to be my favorite.
Agradezco a la presencia de estos dos agradables chicos que vinieron a la taquería de Lupita para hacer un documental de la comida tradicional.
Muchas gracias. This is Guadalupe and Pedro, the owner. owners here at Taqueria La Lupita. You must come visit them if you are in Merida.
Muchas gracias.
Thank you.
Muchas gracias.
Gracias. Thank you.
So literally almost right next door to Taqueria La Lupita here in the Mercado de Santiago is another iconic spot that's been around since 1963 selling Yucatecan food. So we're gonna try a very special dish here. Smells so good.
Primero se pone este.
Tortilla?
Sí.
Oil?
Turkey.
Turkey. So here we have sopa de lima, which is a very popular lime soup here in Merida. Now this consists of really crispy tortilla crisps mixed with turkey meat, as well as that lime broth that is made with local limes as well as a bunch of other spices. But it just smells really, really tangy. This looks really good, and it is packed with turkey and those tortilla crisps on the bottom. So it looks like they topped it off with some onion and pepper, but it's so packed. Look at that. So unique with those crispy tortillas as well. And we have a couple of slices of lime, as if there wasn't enough lime in there already. So nice and hot as well. Okay, just dripping. Cheers. That's sour. You can really taste the limes in this soup. It has a tang to it, a really big zing from those limes, and it's really acidic actually. Oh, quite unique with the sourness of it, but it's a bit peppery as well. But I honestly love the use of those crispy tortillas. They're so crunchy, as well as that turkey meat. It's so tender, and again, here in Merida, it's so unique having turkey meat in all of the dishes, and so many of the dishes. You don't see that in the rest of Mexico, and it's truly, truly unique and tasty. Oh yeah, that's sour. That definitely brings a sourness to the soup.
Like it wasn't sour enough.
That's a lime soup, all right. So good.
Muy rico.
Yeah,
riquísimo. Very tasty, unique. Very good with the lime taste. Oh, it's so good. Yeah, very different. Yeah, Merida taste, right?
Yes, yes.
Muy rico.
Gracias, gracias. I really like this sopa de lima. It is so light and fresh tasting because of the limes, and even the meat inside being turkey and not usually like a red meat, it is much lighter tasting than anything else here in Mexico. This is a delicious soup. Usually you would have to squeeze lime into a lot of the dishes here in Mexico, but this is already made with all of the local limes here in Merida, so you don't need any extra lime squeezing in this. And it's just so tasty. With Mexico being one of the largest producers of limes as well in the world and exporters, this truly just shows why limes are so important and so tasty here in this country. So sour, but so delicious.
We're here at Chain Cocina Yucateca, which is a restaurant that specializes in Yucatecan cuisine. To start off, we have got this delicious dip called Sikil Pak. Now this is a pumpkin seed dip, so it's made of pepitas, and it's a very traditional dish here in the Yucatan. Got some nice crispy tortillas here to go with it. Look, oh, that is thick, look at that. Cheers. Oh wow, actually has a nuttiness to it. That is super tasty. It's got some fresh greens in there. Tastes like a bit of spring onion maybe. That is really nice and rich and super nutty. That is super tasty. With the nuttiness, of the Seco pack. This is a perfect little antojito to start our meal here.
Puerco entomatado. Ah. Esto de puerco entomatado y con su huevo duro.
Bien, el negro.
Sí. Este es el boot.
Oh, wow.
Este.
Wow.
We have two very Yucatecan dishes here. The first is a relleno negro, which is super black. Look at that. So this is what we had on the panucho this morning, except this one is made with pork and chicken. Got a nice big hard-boiled egg there. And then we also have our lomitos de valladolid. Yeah, that's the one. And look at this, beautiful, nice and red. So this is with pork, nice big chunks of diced pork, as well as hard-boiled egg on top. And this is served with rice, which is a little bit different. We've also got this amazing gourd full of tortilla. So you can see we've got nice pieces of egg on top there, as well as these huge chunks of pork. Look at that. You can see it's in such a nice, red, rich, spicy tomato sauce. Look at that. It's got a nice big bite here, big piece of pork, and some of this nice fresh rice. Love this big chunk of pork. Mmm. Oh, that is very unique. Mmm. Muy rico. Muy, muy rico.
Oh.
Delicioso. The pork, so tender, oh my goodness. Just melts in your mouth, wow. Muchas, muchas gracias, muy, muy rico, riquísimo. That is the lovely chef. So you can see that all these dishes are just very home-cooked meals. And this one specifically is from Valladolid, which is a city just outside of Merida. So it's a Yucatanian dish from a place that's known for their stews. And honestly, like I said, that piece of pork just melted in my mouth. I didn't even need teeth to chew it, to be honest with you. It just fell apart. The sauce of this Yucatecan dish is actually quite different and unique compared to other things we've tried in Mexico so far. It's very tomato-y, and honestly, it's not spicy at all. I want to try a little bit with the egg, though, to get the full effect here. Gotta have a little frijoles to go with it there. I'm just gonna spoon it on. Big bite with everything. Oh, add a little bit of richness to that bite. Mmm, okay, that's nice with the beans. They add a little heartiness to it, but honestly, I'd say personally, it almost takes away from the flavor of the dish itself, so I actually think I might prefer it just on its own without the added beans. That pork is really the shining star of this dish. I just can't believe how tender it is. Mmm, okay. But we must move on because there's a whole other meal going on over here. In our relleno negro, we've got pork, chicken, as well as this interesting piece that looks like bread, but I believe is actually pork blood. So let's get a bit of this. Ooh, wow, it's quite firm, and oh, look at that. So black on the inside, just soaking up the sauce. And what makes the relleno negro so black are those chilies that are roasted and toasted until they're pretty much burnt. and they turn it to a black color, and they're ground up to make the sauce, and that's what makes it just so, so rich. Oh my gosh, that piece, it just kind of falls apart. It's like a sponge. Look at that. All right. Actually just tastes like a sausage. It's actually very flavorful, just sausagey. And that meat is super tender. And the sauce has got quite a nice kick to it actually. There's a spiciness that's just so rich from those peppers, but with them being burnt like that, it gives it such an incredible smokiness that is just so different than any other sauce. It's so unique, the use of eggs in the Yucatecan cuisine. Oh, look at this guy, nice and hard boiled there. So far today, what I've loved about this Yucatecan cuisine is just how different it is. They use quite a few different ingredients in their dishes, and also just with the use of some of the spices and everything. I just love as well how black this dish is. Look at that. The color is just incredible. Fresh tortillas straight off the comal, nothing better.
Oh, wow. Castacan.
Castacan. Saco.
Wow.
Bellissimo.
Look at that.
Muchas gracias. This is the owner of YNA here. His name is Mauricio. He's been running this taqueria since 1991, so a very long time. And they're especially known for their castacan tacos, which are pork belly tacos. And he just cut us a big slice there. Look at that pork belly. Wow. Bellissimo, Mauricio. Yeah. All right, cheers. Oh, muy rico. Wow, that fat on that pork belly is like melting your mouth. Oh wow, the meat so tender, that pork belly. Oh, riquísimo, Mauricio. Oh, amazing. Oh my gosh. And we're gonna grab some tacos now. So here at Wayane, they specialize in tacos de guisado, which are the casserole stew-like tacos. You can see all the different varieties here. We have vegetarian ones here and meat ones over here. So we have the special castacan pork belly here, which they have chopped up. So this is their most popular guisado. Look at all that chopped up pork belly there. It looks amazing. This dish is super heavy, and I can't wait to try the taco out. Here we have our special castacan pork belly tacos. These look delicious. So we have one with cheese, a castacan with manchego cheese, as well as plain castacan pork belly with the frijoles sprinkled on top with onion, as well as a morilla blood sausage taco. So this is a pork blood sausage, which we haven't had yet here in Mexico. These are three special, special tacos. And we have a chaya drink, which we had earlier today, as well as a nice cold fresh horchata. We have three salsas to go with our tacos as well, a verde, a rojo, as well as a special habanero salsa, which the Yucatan state is known for, and they make a special one here at this restaurant. These tacos are piping hot, and wow, look how stringy that cheese is. Oh my goodness. Woo. Oh, with that pork belly, oh my gosh, so rich and tasty. That manchego cheese, oh my gosh, so good. Let's try the taco out now. Oh my gosh, so much pork going on. Amazing. Ugh.
Rico. More rico. Oh, riquísimo.
Okay.
The cheese, the pork belly.
Delicious.
So good. Oh, so delicious.
The pork belly is super ultra tender, and with that manchego cheese, that aged cheese, it gives it such a nice flavor. Cheesy, a bit stringy, but honestly just a bit stronger than the usual quesillo cheese that is used in a lot of the dishes here in Mexico. But oh, just a tasty, tasty taco. Let's put some of that habanero on there. You can see this habanero salsa is quite liquidy. It's a lot less thick than other salsas that we've had. Look at that. Let's get some of this on our castacan with cheese, as well as our castacan with the frijoles, and a little bit on our blood sausage there. That habanero salsa smells spicy. Mmm. Yeah. That's got a bite to that. Mmm. But so flavorful. Oh, my lips are a bit tingly now. Okay, I wanna try this pork sausage, this blood pork sausage out. You can see the big pieces of the blood sausage there. Really juicy and fatty as well. Just look at that. So dark, blood sausage. Mmm, it's got a strong flavor of the grill. Really nice charred flavor, and you can really taste that blood sausage. It's got quite a mild blood taste, but super, super porky and fatty and greasy, so you almost wouldn't know that you're eating pork's blood. Mostly just tastes like nice spicy pork because of that habanero, actually. Mmm, that's a super unique taco. Let's move on to our last castacan taco with the frijoles, those refried beans, and just look at these pieces of pork there. Just so fatty and juicy, and just big pieces in those tacos too. They're absolutely filled to the brim. Let's get some of our red salsa on this one here. These castacan tacos are so unique. We haven't had pork belly tacos here in Mexico, and these are just ultra, ultra delicious. Again, that pork belly is just melt in your mouth. It's so soft, the fat just melts like butter, and the frijoles adds a bit of a heaviness to the taco, but it's nice. But honestly, I could just eat the pieces of the pork belly all day. The pork belly is honestly so succulent, and what's special is that they use hairless black pigs that are native to the Yucatan region, so the pork is just so, so delicious. Wow, what an experience here. These pork tacos, these castacan tacos, are the definite must when you're here at Wayane. Just amazing. Oh. Mmm. We are ending our food tour today with a sweet Merida treat that only comes out at nighttime.
Hola. Buenas noches.
Buenas noches. Muchas gracias.
We are here at Marquesitas El Tony for
Marquesitas.
Look at this guy. So this is a rolled waffle dessert that's filled with a bunch of stuff.
So we got ours El Tipico, which is the most popular here in Merida, and it is full of Nutella and grated Edam cheese, which is that Dutch aged cheese.
That smells so cheesy.
So cheesy. It's like this guy's got a little head of hair here.
Look at that.
A little tuft on top.
All right, you go for it. All right. Go for the first bite. Ooh, that is crispy.
That is so cheesy. Look at that.
His hair's falling out.
I can actually barely taste the Nutella because it's just so cheesy. But that cheese is so rich and salty.
Okay.
Get yourself a bite. That's a much bigger bite. Look at all that melty Nutella in there. It's so nice and warm and gooey.
Yeah, and it goes actually perfect with that strong, sharp flavored aged cheese actually. It's really a good combo, chocolate and cheese.
Oh, I actually really like that. Love Nutella, hazelnut, so good.
And the waffle, ultra crispy.
And it's so thin and light. So actually I feel like the majority of it is just the ingredients on the inside. It's just cheesy and rich with that Nutella. Oh my God.
It's exploding with cheese, actually.
This is really good. This is really, really good.
This is a perfect nighttime street food here in Merida.
Oh, it's like gooing out of there. Nutella.
Tony.
Hola.
Riquísimo.
Muy rico.
Oh, muy, muy rico.
Muy rico.
Cuando gusten, cuando gusten.
Oh, the Nutella cheese. Sí, yeah. Queso.
Nutella queso. Mordico.
Perfecto.
So, so good.
This is the perfect nighttime snack.
Yeah, and as I was saying earlier, you can see a lot of these Marquesita carts come out at nighttime, so this is definitely the perfect thing to end our food tour with. Mm. Ooh, shizzies? Ultimate Marquesita bite.
Oh, that sweet and that cheese.
All right, that does it for our food tour here in Merida. Thank you all so much for watching. If you enjoyed the video, share it with your friends and family. Hit that like button to give the video a thumbs up. And don't forget to subscribe to our channel to keep caught up on all of our food adventures. We're hungry to travel, and we'll see you next meal.